So today we shall see the unit number 4, that is balancing. Okay, so first of all we need to understand, so in many applications, so if you take many examples like machines and automobiles, so any other applications where it involves the moving parts, where the motion of the parts is going to take place, so in that cases unbalance is common phenomenon. So we are going to see the that is unbalanced forces produced in the rotary or reciprocating machinery due to the inertia forces associated with the moving masses. Now why the unbalanced forces are going to create? The reason is, so wherever there is a motion of parts, maybe reciprocating or maybe rotating motion, so in that cases, so because of the inertia forces, so unbalance is going to create. So because of a particle or a mass moving in a circular path experiences a centripetal acceleration. Dekho, a particle or mass moving in a circular path experiences a centripetal acceleration and force is required to produce it. देखो इन सर्कुलर फोर्सेस वी आर गोइंग टू क्लासिफाई द फोर्स इन टू टाइप्स, वन इज सेंट्रीपिटल, अदर वन इज सेंट्रीफ्यूगल. सेंट्रीपिटल इज ड्यू टू द अप्लाइड फोर्स, सेंट्रीफ्यूगल इज ड्यू टू द इनर्सिया फोर्स. सो एन इक्वल एंड अपोजिट फोर्स इज एक्टिंग रेडियली आउटवर्ड, एक्ट्स ऑन द एक्सिस ऑफ रोटेशन एंड इज नोन एज द सेंट्रीफ्यूगल फोर्स. So these two forces are very very important, that is centripetal and centrifugal. So here this centripetal and centrifugal, so centrifugal force both are should be equal and opposite, otherwise what will happen is, so it will going to create the unbalance in the machines and automobiles. So this is a disturbing force of on the axis of rotation, the magnitude of which is constant but direction changes with rotation of the mass. Dekho force kya hota hai in rotations, force magnitude remains same but its direction is, means its angle is go on changes. So in revolving rotor the centrifugal force remains balanced as long as, dekho, so it's very important. In revolving rotor, centrifugal force remains balanced as long as the center of the mass of the rotor lies on the axis of rotation. When the body is going to rotate, any body, its center of rotation should be on the CG, matlab center of gravity of that particular object. देखो जब वेन एवर द बॉडी इज गोइंग टू रोटेट, सो इट रोटेट्स अबाउट द सर्टन एक्सिस, सो उसको हम क्या बोलते हैं, सो दैट इज कॉल्ड द एक्सिस ऑफ रोटेशन. एंड वेन देर इज अ बॉडी मीन्स इट शुड हैव सम सीधी, दैट इज सेंटर ऑफ ग्रेविटी. सो सेंटर ऑफ ग्रेविटी शुड बी लाई ऑन द एक्सिस ऑफ रोटेशन, अदरवाइज वाइस वर्सा, देन ओनली द बॉडी विल बी अंडर बैलेंस्ड. सो इफ दिस डज नॉट एग्जिस्ट, then it will going to create the unbalance in the machines, any moving parts. Dekho, a simple example hai. When the center of the mass does not lie on the axis of, or there on the axis, so there is an eccentricity, so it is called the eccentricity, and unbalanced force is produced because of this eccentricity, unbalanced force is going to be produced. So here you can see this figure. So this point G, जी इज द पॉइंट, दिस पॉइंट इज द जी, दैट इज सेंटर ऑफ ग्रेविटी, एंड दिस इज अ रोटर रोटेट्स अबाउट दिस एक्सिस. हियर यू कैन सी द सी जी इज नॉट ऑन द एक्सिस ऑफ रोटेशन. सी जी एक्सिस ऑफ रोटेशन के ऊपर नहीं है. सो इसलिए क्या होता है, सो देर इज एसेंट्रिसिटी. सो एसेंट्रिसिटी मीन्स इट इज अ डिस्टेंस बिटवीन दिस पॉइंट एंड द एक्सिस ऑफ रोटेशन. सो हियर अनबैलेंस्ड फोर्स इज गिवन बाय द एम ई ओमेगा स्क्वायर. सो एम मीन्स इट इज द वट एवर द मास ऑफ रोटर, ई मीन्स इट इज एसेंट्रिसिटी, एंड ओमेगा स्क्वायर मीन्स इट इज ए एंगुलर वेलोसिटी. सो इन दिस वे सो वी आर गोइंग टू क्रिएट द अनबैलेंस्ड फोर्सेस. Suppose you can see here, so if the this center of gravity is on the axis of rotation, if the center of gravity is on the axis of rotation, then eccentricity is zero. Agar eccentricity zero hua to, then unbalanced force will become zero. So that's why, so if the CG is lies on the axis of rotation, then we are going to say that the system is balanced. मतलब हमको क्या समझ में आया, what is meaning of balancing, what is meaning of balancing, how we can define it. Balancing is a process of designing or modifying. Balancing is a process of designing or modifying machinery so that unbalance is reduced to an acceptable level and if possible is eliminated entirely. Abhi dekho, so in actual conditions, in actual conditions, so it is very difficult to, in actual conditions, so it is very difficult to eliminate the entire vibrations. Vibrations ko completely eliminate नहीं कर सकते, ऑलमोस्ट यू कैन से इट इज नॉट पॉसिबल टू एलिमिनेट द ऑल द वाइब्रेशंस एंड मेक इट कंप्लीट बैलेंस. कंप्लीट बैलेंस कभी पॉसिबल नहीं होते. सो इट इज मीन्स बैलेंसिंग इज द प्रोसेस ऑफ डिजाइनिंग और मॉडिफाइंग द मशीनरी सो दैट द अनबैलेंस इज रिड्यूस टू द एक्सेप्टेबल लेवल. मीन्स जो भी अनबैलेंस होता है, सो दैट शुड बी इन सर्टन रेंज, सो विच कैन बी एक्सेप्टेड इन ए पर्टिकुलर एप्लीकेशंस. सो दैट इज कॉल्ड द बैलेंसिंग. सो नेक्स्ट इज व्हाई बैलेंसिंग इज नेसेसरी. अगर बैलेंसिंग नहीं किया तो क्या होता है. सो बैलेंसिंग इज वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट बिकॉज इट विल अननेसेसरली क्रिएट्स द वाइब्रेशंस एंड नॉइजेस इन द मशीन्स एंड ऑटोमोबाइल्स. Wherever there is a moving parts, if it unbalanced, that means it is not balanced, it creates vibrations and noise. So because of which unnecessarily it will going to increase the stresses induced in different parts like bearings, shaft, etc. So because of which failures are going to take place, means unnecessarily it will going to reduce the life of the part or product. So that's why in most applications, so we not require the vibrations, we need to eliminate or reduce the vibrations. So you can see here, so a high speed engines and other machines is a common phenomenon nowadays. Dekho, balancing vibrations are common in case of the high speed engines and other machines. So that's why, so it is therefore very essential that all rotating and reciprocating parts should be completely balanced as far as possible. Because whenever there is a high speed of operation, high speed of rotations, high speed of engines, moving parts, then it should be properly balanced. So otherwise, so unnecessarily it will increase the stresses. So if these parts are not properly balanced, the dynamic forces are set up. These forces not only increase the loads on the bearings and stresses in various members, but also produce the unpleasant and even dangerous vibrations. Dekho, vibrations will going to increase the load, increase the stresses, but also it will going to create the unnecessary noises. So that's why, so we need to eliminate the vibrations. So next is balancing of rotating masses. So how to make, so we are going to classify the balancing into two categories mainly, that is balancing of rotating masses and balancing on reciprocating masses. So in some applications may be combination of rotating and reciprocating masses. So first let us consider balancing of rotating masses. So here in case of balancing of rotating masses, the process of providing second mass in order to counterattack the effect of centrifugal force of the first mass is called the balancing of rotating masses. अभी देखो हम बैलेंस कैसे करते हैं, हाउ नॉर्मली वी आर गोइंग टू डू द बैलेंसिंग. सो वेन एवर देर इज अनबैलेंस मीन्स देर इज सम फोर्स, उसको काउंटर अटैक करने के लिए, उसको बैलेंस करने के लिए हम सेम मैग्नीट्यूड का फोर्स अपोजिट डायरेक्शन में उसको अप्लाई करते हैं. सो उसके बाद आफ्टरवर्ड्स सो इट विल बी बैलेंस्ड. सो बैलेंसिंग इज बेसिकली क्लासिफाइड इन टू टू टाइप्स, स्टैटिक बैलेंसिंग एंड डायनेमिक बैलेंसिंग. Okay, static balancing means it is the net dynamic force acting on the shaft is equal to zero. Matlab total algebraic sum of forces is equal to zero. If this condition satisfies, then we are going to say that system is in static balance. That is, this requires that line of action of three centrifugal forces must be the same. Means whatever the force acting, that's line of action should be same. In other words, so in simple words you can say that center of the masses of system must lie on the axis of rotation, means CG of the body or system should lie on the axis of rotation. So this is simple sentence you can say for the static balancing. So this is the condition of static balancing. Next is dynamic balancing. Dynamic balancing means the net couple due to dynamic forces acting on the shaft is equal to zero. Dekho, net couple means it is a moments, that is algebraic sum of moments about any point in a plane must be zero. Matlab, if the summation of moments are zero, then we say that system is dynamically balanced. If summation of forces is zero, then we say that system is statically balanced. Means balancing is basically classified into two types, static and dynamic. Static means algebraic sum of forces is equal to zero, summation of force are equal to zero. Dynamic balancing means summation of couples or summation of moments is equal to zero. So next we shall see the step by step how to what procedure is used in case of balancing under different conditions. So here is balancing of single rotating mass by a single mass rotating in the same plane. If there is a unbalanced mass, so normally we are going to take it as a unbalanced mass is single mass. So it is balanced by using single mass rotating in the same plane. एक mass use करके जो भी unbalanced रहता है उसको balance करने का same plane में use करके. Okay, so next is consider the Consider a disturbing mass M1 attached to the rotating at omega radian per second. So you can see here, simple, I am explaining with figure. Okay. So you can see here, so this M1 is the unbalanced mass. So let us say that M1 is unbalanced mass. This M1 is unbalanced mass, and to balance this mass, जो भी unbalanced mass है इसको balance करने के लिए हमने क्या किया, so M2 mass use किया. So in the same plane, अभी देखो दोनों का plane, M1 and M2 का plane कौन सा है, they are in the same plane, but हम उसको opposite direction में attach किया. That means, so this M2 mass is in same plane but in opposite direction. We have balanced this mass by using the single mass in a same plane. Okay. So इसमें देखो, this is a M1 unbalanced mass and this is M2 unbalanced mass. Okay. So R1 means it is radius of rotation of first mass, and R2 means it is radius of rotation of second mass. Second mass means देखो, first M1 means it is a unbalanced mass. So unbalanced mass having radius of rotation is R1. So means it is a rotating masses. So they are rotating mass. They are, this M1 mass is rotating about this axis of rotation. This is axis of rotation. इस axis पे ये mass क्या कर रहे हैं? ये rotate कर रहे हैं. Means it is a unbalanced mass. उतना अनबैलेंस है रोटेशन में. उसको बैलेंस करने के लिए, सो वी हैव यूज्ड द मास M2, वी हैव यूज्ड द मास M2 व्हिच इज इन सेम प्लेन. सो दिस इज अ प्लेन, सो दिस इज अ प्लेन, यू कैन सी दैट दिस इज अ प्लेन. M1 and M2 are in the same plane, but they are in opposite direction. They are in opposite direction. So here, in this way, so we can balance the masses, unbalanced masses, by using the single mass, but in the same plane. In second condition also, you can see here. So this is the unbalanced mass M1, and this is unbalanced mass M2. So these two also here also you can see, so this also having the same plane of rotation. So it is also having the same plane, you can see here. So this is the same plane line of the, so in this way, so if there is a single mass, we can balance the system by using the single mass in the same plane. So unbalanced force, how to calculate unbalanced force? So this is the centripetal force. So how to calculate that? Centripetal force is given by FC1 is equal to M1 into M1 omega square into R1. So this is a unbalanced force. So normally centripetal force is given by the MR omega square. So here it is FC1 is equal to M1 omega square into R1. So next, whenever this is the unbalanced force, centripetal force, so if you want to use the mass M2 for balancing, then it should also produce the same force, that is equal to M1 omega square R1. Jo balance karne ke liye jo mass use karta hai, suppose let us say here it is M2. M2 mass is not important, magnitude M2, M1 and M2 equal hona chahiye, aisa kuch nahi. But M1 omega square R1 should be equal to M2 omega square into R2. So depending upon the what you can say, normally angular velocity will be same, but only changes is M and R. So if you use the R value, if the R2 value is more than R1, then we can use the small mass. M2 will be less than M1. But product of M1 into R1 should be equal to the M2 into R2. Then only this system can be balanced. Means kya hota hai? Algebraic sum of forces will become 0. then we can say it is a statically balanced. So in case of the this in case of this type of balancing, like where we are going to where we are using the only one mass for balancing, so here it is not possible for dynamic balancing. Means it's not possible to have the summation of moments are equal to zero. Means unnecessarily it will going to create the some moments. So that's why normally this technique is not used. Okay, देखो ultimately so what we need to do is m1 देखो fc1 is equal to m1 omega square r1 and fc2 is equal to m2 omega square r2. fc1 means it is a centripetal force due to m1 means unbalanced force. m2 means it is balancing force. So उसका centripetal force कौन सा है m2 omega square into r2 for balancing. So m1 omega square r1 is equal to m2 omega square r2. मतलब दोनों का force equal होना चाहिए, only direction is opposite. So omega square will get cancels. So next it will become m1 r1 is equal to m2 r2. That means so for properly balancing m1 r1 should be equal to the m2 r2. Normally balancing mass should be normally we are going to use small amount of mass. So by using the large radius ko increase karke hum m2 ko value ko reduce kar sakte hai. So only thing is its product should be equal, m1 r1 product should be equal to the m2 and r2. So here you can see, so this is a disturbing mass and this is axis of rotation and this is a balancing mass. Okay, so next is balancing of single rotating mass by two masses. So in previous case so we have used the single mass, here it is two masses rotating in different planes. So normally using single mass, अगर एक ही मास यूज किया तो सो इट इज वेरी डिफिकल्ट टू मेक सिस्टम प्रॉपरली बैलेंस्ड, डायनेमिक बैलेंसिंग नहीं होता है. तो इसलिए नॉर्मली क्या होता है, सो वी आर गोइंग टू यूज द टू मासेस. सो टू मासेस में देयर आर टू कंडीशंस, टू केसेस. अभी देखो सो हियर इट इज एम मीन्स इट इज ए डिस्टर्बिंग मास. So m1 and m2 are the two balancing masses. Here we are going to use the two balancing masses m1 and m2. M is the disturbing mass. So by here what we are doing is we are going to make the balancing by using the two masses m1 and m2. But here important thing is when the disturbing mass is, when the plane of disturbing mass lies in between the planes of the two balancing masses. Matlab jo disturbing mass ka plane hai, so it is in between balancing masses m1 and m2, dono ka beech mein hai. So let us say l is the plane of mass m1, m is the plane of mass m2, and here a is the plane of the mass m. So plane A is in between the plane L and M. So in this case how to make balancing, abhi dekho. So here L1 is the distance between plane A and L, plane A and L distance is L1, and plane A and M is distance is L2, and L is the distance between plane L and M. So distance L is the between distance, L is the distance between plane L and M. So here this M is the disturbing mass, so it is going to rotate about the this rotational axis. दिस फोर्स ड्यू टू मास एम वन इज गिवन बाय एम वन आर वन ओमेगा स्क्वायर. ओमेगा क्या होता है इधर? एंगुलर वेलोसिटी. एंगुलर वेलोसिटी इज कॉन्स्टेंट फॉर एनी मासेस, ऑल द मासेस, बिकॉज सभी ऑल द मासेस आर अटैच टू द सेम शाफ्ट. सो इसलिए सो एंगुलर वेलोसिटी ओमेगा विल बी सेम फॉर एम वन एम टू एंड एम. सो आर वन इज द रेडियस ऑफ रोटेशन ऑफ द मास एम वन, आर टू इज द रेडियस ऑफ रोटेशन ऑफ मास एम टू, एंड आर इज द रेडियस ऑफ रोटेशन ऑफ द मास एम. सो एम मीन्स हियर इट इज डिस्टर्बिंग मास, मीन्स इट इज अनबैलेंस्ड मास. एम वन एंड एम टू आर द टू बैलेंसिंग मासेस वी आर यूजिंग टू मेक द बैलेंस. देखो सेंट्रीपिटल फोर्स ड्यू टू मास एम इज गिवन बाय एफ सी इक्वल टू एम ओमेगा स्क्वायर इंटू आर. सिमिलरली सेंट्रीपिटल फोर्स ऑफ द मास एम वन इज गिवन बाय एफ सी वन इज इक्वल टू एम वन ओमेगा स्क्वायर इंटू आर वन. सिमिलरली एफ सी टू इज इक्वल टू एम टू ओमेगा स्क्वायर इंटू आर टू. सो फॉर स्टैटिक बैलेंसिंग डिस्टर्बिंग फोर्स शुड बी इक्वल टू द बैलेंसिंग फोर्सेस, समेशन ऑफ बैलेंसिंग फोर्सेस. एफ सी इज इक्वल टू एफ सी वन प्लस एफ सी टू. सो इफ वी सब्स्टिट्यूट द वैल्यू ऑफ एफ सी, एफ सी वन एंड एफ सी टू, सो ओमेगा इज कैन ओमेगा स्क्वायर इज कॉमन ऑन बोथ साइड्स, सो ओमेगा स्क्वायर इज गोइंग टू गेट कैंसल. सो वॉट विल रिमेन इज एम आर इज इक्वल टू एम वन आर वन प्लस एम टू आर टू. सो नाउ now in order to find the magnitude of balancing forces in the plane L, so what we need to do is take moments about P, which is the point of intersection of plane M and the axis of rotation. So isme humko kya karna padega, we need to take the moment about point P. So point P means kya hai, it is a point of intersection of plane M and the axis of rotation. So if you take the moment about point P, what will happen is FC1 is equal to FC1 into L is equal to FC into L2. देखो the moment we are taking is about point P. तो इसलिए FC2, FC2 means centripetal force due to mass M2, इसका moment क्या हो जाता है? जीरो हो जाता है, because its line of action is passing through this point. Only we are going to take the moment of moment of mass m1, that is centripetal force due to mass m1, force into distance fc1 into distance kitna hota l. So m1 ka distance kitna hota hai point p tak, perpendicular distance it is l, and mass m ka perpendicular distance kitna hota hai l2. Okay, isliye fc1 into l is equal to fc1 into l is equal to fc into l2, or so we can substitute the value of fc1 and fc. So ultimately we are going to get the m1 r1 is equal to mr into l2 by l1. Similarly if you take the moment about point p, sorry point m, agar point m ke upar hum point m pe moment liya to, so we get the equation as fc2 into l is equal to fc into l1. मतलब इस टाइम पे मोमेंट ड्यू टू फोर्स एफ सी वन विल बी जीरो, बिकॉज सो वी आर गोइंग टू टेक द मोमेंट अबाउट पॉइंट एम. ओके, सो सिमिलरली वी आर गोइंग टू गेट द इक्वेशन एज एम टू इंटू आर टू इज इक्वल टू एम इंटू आर इंटू एल वन बाय एल. सो हियर वी नीड टू अंडरस्टैंड दैट, वी नीड टू अंडरस्टैंड दैट इक्वेशन वन रिप्रेजेंट्स द कंडीशन फॉर द स्टैटिक बैलेंस. कौन सा इक्वेशन वन? सो दिस इज द इक्वेशन वन, दैट इज एम आर इज इक्वल टू एम आर वन प्लस एम टू एम सॉरी एम आर इज इक्वल टू एम वन आर वन प्लस एम टू आर टू. दिस इज द कंडीशन ऑफ कंडीशन फॉर द स्टैटिक इक्विलिब्रियम, एंड इफ द सिस्टम सेटिस्फाइज इक्वेशन वन, एंड also 2 or 3. देखो, so So in order to achieve the dynamic balance, equations 2 or 3 must also be satisfied. So matlab this is equation 3. So next this is equation 2. So this is equation 2. Equation 2 kaun sa hai? M1 R1 is equal to MR into L2 by L1. So this is the equation 2, and M2 into R2 is equal to MR into L1 by L. So this is equation 3. For dynamic balancing, equation 1 plus equation 2 or 3 must be satisfied. Then only we can say that system is dynamically balanced. So again, when the plane of disturbing mass lies on the one end of the planes, when the plane of disturbing mass lies on the one end of the planes of the balancing masses. So in case, previous case, so disturbing mass is in between balancing masses, plane of the balancing masses. Abhi idhar kaise disturbing mass is, disturbing mass lies on the one end of the balancing masses. So ye beech mein nahi hai, so it's side pe, one end. So this is disturbing mass, this is balancing mass M1, and this is balancing mass M2. And let us say the distances L2, L and L1. L1 means it is, so distance of the mass M, that is disturbing mass M from plane L. L2 is distance of disturbing mass M from the plane M, and L is the distance between plane L and M. So mass M1 is on the plane L, mass M2 is on the plane M. Again same here, R1 is the radius of rotation of mass M1, and R2 is the radius of rotation of mass M2, and R is the radius of rotation of mass M. So here also we are going to apply the same conditions. So again we need to apply the condition FC. Okay. Okay, so for balancing of masses, so this should satisfy the equation, that is FC plus FC2 is equal to FC1. Mass M and M2. So here, so FC plus FC2 is equal to FC1. So here you can see that is force due to this mass and this mass, this two summation should be equal to this one. Okay, so that is FC is equal to FC plus FC2 is equal to FC1. So we can substitute the value of FC, means it is M omega square into R. So this means simply substitute karne ke values of FC, FC1 and FC2. So ultimately we are going to get the so MR plus M2 R2 is equal to M1 R1. So this is the condition for the static equilibrium. So next is dynamic equilibrium. So for dynamic equilibrium, so we need to consider the moment or couple. Now to find the balancing of forces in the plane L, so we need to take the moment about point P. Agar point P pe agar moment liya to kya hota hai? So if you take the moment about point P, then so moment due to force M2, that is FC2 will be equal to 0. Okay. So remaining is FC1 and FC. FC1 into L is equal to FC into L2. So moment means kya hai? Force into perpendicular distance. अगर किस पॉइंट पे मोमेंट लेता है फोर्स पे अगर उसी पॉइंट थ्रू पास हो रहे हैं तो उसका मतलब क्या होता है परपेंडिकुलर डिस्टेंस जीरो हो जाता है तो उस टाइम पे उसका मोमेंट जीरो हो जाता है FC1 into L is equal to FC into L2 so substitute the value of FC and FC1 so we are going to get this similarly in previous place M1 R1 is equal to MR into L2 by L1 Similarly, if you take the moment about point 1, so we get the M2 R2 is equal to M into R into L1 by L. So, in this case also, so the equation 4, 5 and 6 should be satisfied for the equation 4 should be satisfied for static balancing and for dynamic balancing. Equation 4 also Equation 5 or 6 should be balanced for dynamic balancing. So in this way, so we are going to use the, we are going to calculate the, what you can say, unbalanced masses. Means we are going to make the system balanced. अगर हमने unbalanced mass को identify किया, उसको balance कैसे करना चाहिए, कितना mass चाहिए, किधर mass को attach करने के, तो सब everything so we can get from these equations after doing calculations so we can understand so in the again so in the next lecture so I am going to sorry okay So, in the next lecture, so I am going to explain you about the next topics. So, next lecture also in theories, I think it is 3 to 4 slides it is there. So, afterwards, so I am going to solve the problems. So, once you solve some problems, so then you can understand more clearly of this concept that is balancing. Okay. So bye, take care, so see you in the next lecture.